A Delaware judge is allowing Dominion Voting to press forward in a major defamation case against Fox News after finding the network's coverage of election fraud may have been inaccurate. Delaware Superior Court Judge Eric Davis writes in his ruling, quote, given that Fox apparently refused to report contrary evidence, including evidence from the Department of Justice, the complaint's allegations support the reasonable inference that Fox intended to keep Dominion's side of the story out of the narrative. Now, that ruling is going to now allow Dominion to attempt to uncover extensive communications within Fox News and interview the network's top people under oath. This comes just days after the January 6th committee released text messages from some Fox News hosts to then White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows urging the former president to stop the Capitol insurrection. Joining us now, former Nixon White House counsel and CNN contributor John Dean and former federal prosecutor and CNN chief legal analyst Jeffrey Toobin. Jeff, this is a big deal?
It's a very big deal, but it's not a surprise. You know, it's a basic principle of libel law is that if CNN puts Mr. A on the air and Mr. A says Mr. B is a child molester, Mr. B sues us, we can't say, oh, well, it was just Mr. A who said that. We were just the transmission. That's what this case is about. Fox said, no, we didn't say that Dominion is corrupt. The people we interviewed said that. The judge said, first of all, some of these people, Tucker Carlson, Maria Bartiromo, Lou Dobbs, among others, some of those did say that Dominion was corrupt. But by putting Rudy Giuliani, Sidney Powell, making these outrageous false allegations on the air, without allowing Dominion to refute them, that's libel. And that's what Fox is going to have to defend. And I don't know how they're going to defend it. I think it's a very good case for the plaintiffs.
John, legally, how difficult is it to prove individuals knew their statements were false or that they were intentionally leaving out relevant information?
It's not easy. In fact, it's very surprising. Most of these cases get dismissed at this very early stage with a motion to dismiss. I think that probably handles overwhelming number of defamation cases because the standard is very unique. They have to show actual malice that was employed, meaning that they either knew it was false and went ahead with it, or they did it with reckless disregard. They had some indication, but yet they still went ahead. And this case has not been decided on any substance yet, just on the pleadings, and it made the basic bar and got over that, which is going to be a nightmare for Fox, Jeffrey says. They're going to now dig in deep, and it's not going to be easy.
But, John, this case is the definition, so it appears, of reckless disregard. Most cases, you're right, gets dismissed because most competent, ethical, journalistic entities put the other side of the story out. That's what Fox didn't do. And you have Giuliani saying, he's admitted already, that he didn't check out these allegations. So that means Fox didn't check out the allegations. And you can't just put libelous false information out without allowing the other people to return. And plus, Dominion says that they lost all kinds of business because of this, which is certainly understandable given the fact that a lot of Republican, you know, will never hire them again. I mean, it's a very good case for the plaintiffs.
So are the people who said those things, not, you know, who were Fox personalities, who were Fox employees, are they personally liable?
Not in this case. Uh-huh. There are other cases percolating through the system. Certainly there are cases against Giuliani and Sidney Powell. They have incredibly difficult cases to defend because they were putting all this stuff out here.
I mean, they were saying wild things.
Totally wild things. And, you know, reckless disregard for the truth, as John said, is the standard. But I don't see how you can look at what Giuliani and Powell did and now what Fox did without concluding it was reckless disregard.
Here with us, CNN chief media correspondent and anchor of Reliable Sources, Brian Stelter, an anchor of Early Start and attorney at law, Laura Jarrett. Brian, this is a serious lawsuit.
Yes, and now that you can see they are moving forward, Dominion has won this key victory. This is a situation where Fox will settle and pay many, 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 many millions of dollars in order to make this go away, or they will, you know, go forward and actually let depositions happen and have executives be deposed and hosts be deposed and emails be turned over. And there could be some very embarrassing information in these emails and these correspondence, you know, from November and December of last year. Fox was touting the big lie, fueling the fire that led to the riot. We know that. And this lawsuit may expose even more of that. But again, that's only if Fox decides not to settle at this point. Or if Dominion's not willing to settle. That's the other factor here.
Yeah.
Dominion may not want to settle. Dominion Voting Systems wants to regain its reputation. It may not be willing to settle. It may fight this all the way to court.
And they have had a lot of court cases. This is not just their only one, because they're really frustrated. They say it hurt their company the way that what was said about them. And
right.
They also said, I thought something was interesting, that the judge took into consideration that Dominion went to Fox and said, this is why the information that you have is wrong. Here's proof that it's not true. And they're saying that is what factored into it, that they did reach out to them and try to say, hey, here's why this is wrong.
They went to the highest levels of Fox executives to say, here's a fact sheet of all the things you've gotten wrong. Here's the DOJ pointing out all the ways you're wrong and the contrary evidence. And yet you still went ahead and put on lie after lie, week after week, which is what goes into the what they call actual malice standard, which is what Dominion has to prove here. It's actually a high bar for them to say, you actually knowingly put on lies. Not just that you sort of washed over, you knowingly put on lies. You knowingly hoodwinked your viewers with all of this crap. And I mean, the judge just saw right through it.
And this is what we're seeing more and more in the last few years. These disputes are being handled now in court. Alex Jones dragged into court, held accountable for his Sandy Hook lies. Now Fox, Newsmax, OAN being dragged into the court system, being held accountable. It's really interesting to see. And this, on top of Fox's maybe worst week in years, Chris Wallace leaving because he'd had enough. Those text messages by Fox News stars showing their rank hypocrisy on January 6th. And now you have this court loss for Fox. It is one damning bit of news after another, showing that there is, at some point, a reality up against these lies.
But imagine, if those were the texts on January 6th, what else do you think is out there? I mean, if Dominion gets what they want, it's not just text messages. They're going to get emails. They're going to get all kinds of internal back and forth. And if they're lucky, which is what they want, they're going to get depositions with some of the key players here. They're going to be able to get depositions with the likes of Sean Hannity and Laura Ingraham, and they're going to be able to question them under oath about what they wrote.
And the significance of this ruling, Laura, this is the stage where most companies try to stop these cases. Like,
yes.
Fox has already lost what is usually the biggest, best hope to squelch
you these. You want to get this squelched on a motion to dismiss. Because all Dominion has to do is say, here are the facts, and they just have to make sort of a bare-bones showing. And the court said that they did that. But the court, I mean, it's a long opinion, and the judge ticked through all of the possible defenses that Fox could try to mount. And the judge is saying, that all might work down the line, but for right now, all of that is sort of besides the point. And they've made a clear enough showing just on the facts of it that they have a clear case here to move forward to discovery.